Oh boy, doubles Pangoro with the Salamence. That actually looks pretty awesome. I think Pangoro is one of the highest potential Pokemon in the game because of all of the move tutors that it got. And we have Lantern, Politoed, Fallen Up. So seeing in doubles is actually fairly surprising because I would imagine you want to support it in singles. Like, just give it momentum to come in with a Choice Scarf and finish off a team really easily. But this is going to be Pangoro Salamence against the opponent that has the Dragonite and the Galvantula. Both shiny, all of my money is that the opponent's next two shiny Pokemon are shiny as well, and his whole team is cheated. Salamence is going to get Intimidate, reducing Dragonite's power substantially, but Pangoro also going to have a lot of good opportunities right here, and then Salamence going into the Mega Evolution. So, yeah, it's going to be interesting to see how this ends up playing out, because yeah, you Hyper Voice, that's going to be Galvantula going down until it gets saved by the Sticky Web, or the Dragon Claw onto Dragonite, so breaking that multi-scale, and that's going to be Dragon Claw traded for the Dragon Claw. Salamence gains a huge buff to its defenses, and Pangoro with the knockoff, just going to go straight into that Dragonite, double focus it down, understanding that Galvantula is not a threat. Getting with a Yache Berry, just in case there was like a super duper ice type attack on top of that multi-scale. And now we are into the hacked Conkeldurr, where we see the Volt Switch onto Salamence. Little bit of a hit. Not enough to finish it out, going to switch out into a new Pokemon, and that's going to be into the Gengar. Also shiny. So Gengar, it doesn't really get to do too much. That's going to be a super Aerolate boosted return onto the Conkeldurr, so that's gone just right there. And Pangoro has the knockoff for the Gengar, and that's gone right there because we can assume that Galvantula is going to hold onto the Focus Sash. Man, the beatdown from this team is unreal. So Galvantula just gets hit twice and loses. I mean, that's all we're going to see. Ooh, actually the Electro Ball going to get that Salamence pretty low, and it will be enough to knock it out. Interesting. All right, so just the damage right there, but the knockoff, that's going to be huge damage. Would be one shot onto the Galvantula. Hangs onto the Focus Sash. Lantern comes in, and nothing matters. So it's kind of Sticky Web. Doesn't really make too much of a difference here. There's the Volt Absorb on the Electro Ball, and then Pangoro with the knockoff. So yeah, I saw that. And with the Mega Salamence, you could really feel the power behind it, and you just scarf the Pangoro to where it outspeeds a lot, and then Salamence, you know, as long as you have that speed control, one shot, well, not one shot city, but you know, you convert a lot of damage really quick, and it seems to be pretty effective. Here's one thing about how I like people playing Pokemon as well. That while it's not always fun to just use the same old super overpowered Pokemon all the time, mixing a powerful Pokemon with a not powerful Pokemon does a lot of really good things as well. That could just been Mega Salamence and then a Scarfed Landorus Therian, but instead go with a Scarfed Pangoro, mix things up, and you still get a good amount of power behind it, and a lot of fun stuff happens. So if you guys enjoyed this video, more Fan Fridays coming up in a bit, and I'll see you guys then.